St. Lucia has stepped up its precautionary measures to restrict the possible entry of the coronavirus into the island. Late Monday afternoon, the Department of Health announced travel restrictions which would affect persons traveling to and from China. St. Lucia's pronouncement followed an emergency meeting of the CARICOM Council for Human and Social Development, where senior health and security officials discussed regional plans and issues related to the virus outbreak. With the escalation of confirmed cases in more than two dozen countries, the island's chief medical officer says the decision was taken to protect the lives of citizens.
The government of St. Lucia will not allow any non-national with a travel history within the last 14 days from mainland China, whether in transit or originating, to enter any local port as of 12 a.m. on Tuesday, February 4th, 2020. Any national returning to St. Lucia with similar travel history will be quarantined for 14 days. The government of St. Lucia commends the Chinese government and authorities in their efforts to manage and contain the outbreak and will continue working to strengthen the local capacities against this global threat.
St. Lucia is the latest nation from the region to impose a travel ban. Other CARICOM nations which have taken that route include Dominica, Grenada, Jamaica, and Trinidad and Tobago. In spite of the decision taken by fellow members to impose travel restrictions, some CARICOM nations have chosen to forgo this preventative measure at present.
All persons entering the island from China will be subject to immediate quarantine for a minimum of 14 days. Quarantine facilities for these persons will be provided by the government of Jamaica, and persons will be required to adhere to all restrictions in line with the provisions under the Quarantine Act.
Health officials from Barbados have chosen to monitor the situation and have instead cautioned citizens against traveling to Wuhan, China, the epicenter of the outbreak. The island's chief medical officer, Dr. Kenneth George, during a call-in program, noted that closing borders would simply not work in most instances and that this preventive measure was counterproductive. The government of Antigua and Barbuda last week announced that it had no immediate plans to issue travel restrictions between the Twin Island nation and China. It instead issued an advisory to persons in China to postpone travel arrangements to Antigua and vice versa. For the DBS News World, I am Zane Romulus.